Today in this session, we are going to discuss how to create strategies on Tritron platform. So I'll just discuss all the keywords and flow of strategy creation, all the advanced settings that are available for a user to handle the execution part. And also we'll see some position management tricks, how you can once a trade is generated, a signal is generated and trade is taken, how you can manage the position using stop loss, target profits. So, okay, we'll start. So today we are going to discuss a mean reversion strategy on Bollinger Band. So I have described the strategy rules here. It will be an intraday strategy, and long trades will be taken when close crosses above the lower Bollinger Band, and short trades will be initiated when close crosses below upper Bollinger Band. To just describe this, what exactly I'm referring is we can see it on chart. So let's say this is a SBI chart on 10-minute candles, and the Bollinger Band parameters, as you can see, is 20 in 2.5. So 2.5 is the multiplier of standard deviation, as Bollinger Band is plotted based on the standard deviation of prices. So 20 period standard deviation, which is multi and it is multiplied by 2.5 to get this Bollinger Band. So now what I'm referring here is whenever the close, like this red candle, has closed below the Bollinger Band, upper Bollinger Band, at this point we will initiate a short trade. Similarly, here again you can see close was above Bollinger Band and close went below upper Bollinger Band. So at close of this candle and open of the third candle, we will in this case 1, 2, 3 and fourth candle. So on open of fourth candle, we will initiate a short trade. Same will happen for long. So if close has gone from below Bollinger Band to under the lower Bollinger Band, then we will initiate a long trade. So this trade might end up in loss. So like that. That is the basic idea. So you can have different parameters, different list of stocks on which you can apply this strategy. And exit rules, we will define as 1% as stop loss, 3% as target profit, or exit time as 3 p.m. We will have an additional filter here, so which is entry time should be before 11 a.m. So if the trigger happens after 11 a.m., then we will not enter the trade. And also we will restrict each stock to be traded only once in a day. So I'll create the strategy on futures list. So I have already created a list called FNO, which has all the FNO stocks in NSE. So I'll just explain you the structure of create strategy page, so it will give you an idea where to start with. So this is a list selector. Here you can select a predefined list, or you can create your own list. You just have to click on add, put the name of your list, select the exchange, and you can keep adding the stocks which you want like this. And you just have to enter a name and save it, and your list will be saved. You can apply the condition on all those stocks from here. Then there can be one or more than one set in every strategy, and every set has its own entry, repair and exit condition. There is a universal exit block for every strategy which can be applied on top of the sets. So it is applied to all the open positions that are there in your strategy. At a strategy level, you can define the universal exit conditions. So we'll discuss that as well when we come to the condition builder part. Then I'll quickly discuss advanced settings. So once a signal, trade signal is generated, you can decide to place the order at market price or any of these options. So let's say if I select LTP, so whenever a signal is generated, let's say I want to buy SBI and its price is 200, let's say. So it will place a limit order at 200. Then after 10 seconds, let's say if after 10 seconds order is not executed at 200 rupees, then I can have an option to increase my bid by 2 ticks. So now it will place order at 200.10, 200.10. Then again, it will wait for 10 seconds. And you can make n such attempts. So let's say I want to make 4 attempts every time, increasing my bid from at LTP plus X number of ticks. And let's say after 4 attempts, if order is not executed, then I can decide to trade at market price, or I can decide to cancel that order. Then also, if you want to trade in cash, let's say, and if you want to trade a multiple number of shares, you can divide that quantity in multiple tranches. Even in futures, let's say if you want to take trade in 4 lots, but you don't want to place order for 4 lots in one go, you can decide to make it as 25% tranching. And between each tranche, you can decide to have a time difference, which you can select from here. At strategy portfolio level, you can decide, let's say, if the strategy is taking 10 trades in one go, then at the strategy level, you can have a trailing stop loss. So I can say if my profit reaches 20,000, then after every rupee increase in profit, increase my trailing stop loss by 1 rupee. So if my profit reaches 30,000, trailing stop loss will stand at 10,000. So as soon as profit goes below 10,000, it will exit all the open positions in my strategy. So you can have such trailing exits as well. Then as whenever strategy enters and makes a universal exit, so strategy cycle is completed from entry to exit. At that time, the run counter is incremented by 1. And once the strategy is exited, you can decide when you want to reactivate your strategy to again check the entry conditions. So let's say if it's an intraday strategy, I'm exiting after 3 p.m. I want it to reactivate itself after 6 hours. So next day it will be ready for new trades. Then in our portfolio manager's plan and institution plan, we are allowing users to check their strategy conditions on continuous basis. So if let's say your one cycle of the conditions check of your strategy takes 2 seconds, so every 2 seconds the strategy will keep checking the condition. If it's very complex and it is taking 5 seconds to complete one round, then every 5 seconds your conditions will be checked like that. And in retail plan, it's limited to 1 minute. So every 1 minute there will be one cycle of all the conditions checked, and based on that the position entry or exit positions will be taken. You can decide to skip first few minutes or last few minutes of exchange timing to avoid any trades to be placed by your strategy or any conditions to be checked. So if I select 5-5 here, so till 9:20 it will not check for any condition and it will not place any order. Same after 3:25 it will not place any order. Here you can define like what will be the ideal capital required to take the strategy. So let's say if you want to put the strategy on TradeTrons marketplace and you want others to subscribe this strategy and follow it, then this figure will help them to understand what is the capital requirement for the strategy. Also on this number, your statistics will be built. So it's a good idea to have a fair knowledge about how much capital the strategy will be required, how much capital will be required to deploy the strategy, and put that number accordingly. So let's say if I put it as 2 lakh for now. Now I come to the strategy creation part. So from here you can add the conditions to your strategy. So every row that you see here is basically a trading rule. So you can have one or more than one rule in your strategy condition. You can add those rules or those rules. You can add a group of rules. So this particular group has 3 rules which can be odd and ended with the major group. You can easily drag and drop these rules inside and outside a group. And what the rule is, so now let's get deeper into it. So you can create simple rules like LTP of my instrument which I'm trading should be greater than some number, let's say 100. So this is a simple trading rule that this condition should be satisfied, then only the trade should happen. So let's come to our original strategy rules. So which is closing. Of previous candles. Here I'll select my list, this FNL. And from symbol, you can select the candle type. So let's say I'm using 10 minute candles for now, and maximum number I'll restrict to 300. So using symbol, you can change the candle type, and based on the indicators you are using and the parameters you are using, you can define maximum how many candles you want for the analysis to be done. So lesser the candles, lesser the time it will take to compute the signal. So an optimized number will give you a better execution time. Closing is greater than lower Bollinger Band. So if I click on Bollinger Band, it will ask me for the parameter. So I can set it to 20 in 2.5. Here again, I will select as NSC. My list name. No. So this is okay. Let's select the candle type as well. So this, I have defined one rule that previous closing should be greater than the lower Bollinger Band value. And I'll add one more condition, which says before that, last to last candle close should be lesser than lower Bollinger Band value. So I have created a crossover condition here using AND. So there are two rules, that previous candles closing should be greater than previous candles lower Bollinger Band, and closing of previous to previous candle should be less than lower Bollinger Band of previous to previous candle. Then it will take the trade on open of next candle. We had another rule that the time of trade should be less than 11 a.m. So time basically returns current time value in HHMM format. So 11 hours, 00 minutes, I have defined that the time should be less than this value, then only it will place the order. Now, when this condition is true, what action do I want to take? So I want to buy a future of FNO, whichever instrument. So we have selected, the list name is already selected there based on the list selection in your set. Order type will be MIS. It will be current month. And number of lots will be one. So like this, you have defined a position. So with every condition, you can have maybe one or more than one set. So let's say if I want to do a covered call instead of buying a naked future, then I can also decide to sell ATM call one lot. So I'm making a covered call position here. So you can do that as well. So you can have n number of legs here based on your requirement, strategy requirement. So we'll keep it simple for now. So it will buy one future. I'm going to add one more set here. So this set will handle the sell position. Before that, we have to select the list here as well. Will be futures MIS order on one lot. Okay, now let's come to the exit part. So stop loss of 1%, target profit of 3%, or if time is greater than 3 p.m. So this exit time applies to all the open positions of my strategy. So this I will put in universal exit condition. So my universal exit condition will be time greater than 15:00, which is 3 p.m. So after 3 p.m., whatever positions are open in the strategy should be exited. This is rule number one. Now let's see how we can apply the stop loss and target profit for individual legs. So if LTP, and select futures from here, LTP of futures of left FNO, it will fetch the last traded price of the future which is traded is greater than entry price, is the keyword which we are going to use here. Entry price basically returns the price at which the instrument was traded. So if you bought SBI at 200 rupees, so this entry price will return 200 rupees as value. So this value should be greater than multiplied by number 1.03. So entry price into 1.03 is basically price 3% above my entry price. So if LTP reaches above this value, I want to exit the position. So like this, I have defined the target profit condition. Similarly, I'll just copy this block, paste it here, or putting my stop loss. Entry price is less than multiplied by again number. I'll click on number and change it to 0.99 to have 1% as stop loss. Like this, I have defined my stop loss. So I'll just copy this set one condition, entry condition. I paste it here. We'll have to make some changes here. In this case, the close should be less than but Bollinger band, upper Bollinger band value, right? We'll select upper Bollinger band here. We'll again have to select candle type because we have changed the keyword. This will be 20 in 2.5. Instrument name will be again so like this. We have defined the entry condition. Okay, we'll make the same changes here as well. Make it position -2. This value should be greater than. Similarly, I'll copy the exit condition. Here only the sign will change. So because you're shorting, then you want LTP to go down and your target profit will be achieved. And here it will be greater than. Okay, and this will be odd because any of this happens, we want to exit the positions. And set one exit as well, it should be odd. So like this, you have created a Bollinger Band mean reversion strategy to buy a future when price crosses above lower Bollinger Band and to short when price crosses below the upper Bollinger Band. With your additional filters of time. One more thing that we can do here is, let's say if you have taken a trade and exit has happened because of stop loss or target profit, but you want to restrict it to take another position. So for this, we have one more keyword, which is called position detail. I'll discuss that the keyword as well. It can help you to manage the entry, multiple entries in your strategy. position detail keyword basically depends based on your selection of condition type, it will return the total traded quantity or value by that condition. So let's say if I select entry condition, transaction type can be buy, sell, or any instrument type. If you're trading with options, you can take all the buy value or buy quantity of all the call options or put options. So it gives you all the functionality in that to select based on any criteria. So if entry value, I'm selecting here is, if entry value of particular instrument, which is my list NFO. Okay. So of the particular instrument, entry value is not equal to zero. If it is equal to zero, then only I want to take the entry. Once the entry is taken, this value will become, either if it's a long trade, it will become positive value, or if it's a short trade, it will become a negative value. Value is nothing but quantity traded into the price. So if that value is equal to zero, then only it will take the trade. So this will restrict multiple entries in one symbol. Similarly, I'll put it in set to entry as well. Entry here. No. It's equal to zero. So again, this will not take multiple entries, even if condition satisfied. And universal exit will happen after 3 p.m. So let's say if any stock doesn't hit target profit or stop loss throughout the day, then at 3 p.m. it will automatically exit all the positions. And after it exit, it will reactivate itself after 6 hours. So at 9 p.m. it will reactivate the strategy, and next day it will take new positions. So I'll keep this standard to place market orders. Okay, now I'll discuss the marketplace settings. So let's say if you are in portfolio manager or institution management plan, and you want to make your strategy public, so you can select yes here. You can define a fixed monthly fee for your subscribers, can be any value that you want, you think your subscribers will be ready to pay you for that. You can also have a percentage variable fee. So let's say if you want to charge on profit only, you don't want to charge a fixed fee, you can do that as well. So let's say 2000 is the fee, but let's say we'll keep it zero for now. Then there are multiple options. You can hide the positions taken by your strategy from non-subscribers. So if they come to your strategy profile page, they won't see what trades have been taken. Of course, they will be able to see the statistics, but not the positions taken by your strategy. But it's a good idea to display the trades, because it gives you a fair idea to the subscribers what kind of trades are being taken by your strategy, the frequency of trades and everything. Then you can keep a public strategy hidden from all the users of Tradetron by keeping this yes. So your strategy will be public, but not listed on Tradetron's marketplace. Only people having linked to your strategy can subscribe and deploy your strategy. You can also confirm each subscriber manually. So once someone subscribes to your strategy, you'll get an email notification from where you have to approve their request. Then only they will be able to follow that strategy. So put this as no. You can also allow others to duplicate your strategy. So I'm going to keep this strategy available for duplication with a private link. So I'm going to share this link on chat, so you can just duplicate the strategy and play around with the parameters and check its performance. And if you find like, okay, if you see on chart that this particular parameter will work better for most of the stocks, then you can do it. You can change the list of stocks. Instead of all FNO stocks, you might want to apply it only on the stocks which are high beta or low beta stocks, based on your study. have updated that. I'm putting this in the start window. So from here, you can duplicate the strategy and play around with the position. Mr. Vedant, can you please explain? Is it clear now how to put the indicators, or you want some other explanation on that? Okay. So, any particular indicator for which you want to see an example? Okay, so I'll just show how you can select MACD or something, a similar indicator. So basically every technical indicator is basically a series of values. So let's say this purple line here is a moving average. So at every candle it will have a different moving average. So we need to give, in condition builder, we need to give the position of this candle, that which moving average of which candle you are referring to, or MACD of which candle you are referring to from the current candle. So current candle position is considered to be zero. This candle will be minus one, this candle will be minus two, and so on. So let's say if I want to take trade based on close of a candle, then always I'll have to put my condition or check my condition on position minus one. Or if it's a crossover, then position minus one and minus two, like that. So for any technical indicator which has a series as output, you have to start with position keyword, and zero stands for current candle and minus one stands for previous candle. Here there is a list of all the indicators that are available. So you can select MACD here. So if I select MACD, now if you click on MACD, then you can change the parameters of MACD. When you click on symbol, you can change the candle type from month, day, week, 1 minute, 3 minute, whatever time frequency you want to trade on. Then you have to select the instrument on which you want to apply this indicator. So it can be a single instrument like SDFC, or it can be a list of Nifty 50 stocks. So it will be applied on each stock separately. It will iterate through the strategy conditions, will iterate through each and every instrument in Nifty 50 stocks. Again, let's say if you want to select apply condition on futures, then you can just select stock, let's say HDFC Bank, and you can select current month. So it will be applied to current month future. So all the indicators that you're defining will be applied to futures. You can also do it on list. So if I select Nifty 50 in current month, so this MACD indicator will be applied on the future instrument of all Nifty 50 stocks at 3 minute candle with 1226 as parameter, and it will return MACD value of previous close or previous candle like this. So I think this should give you more clarity on how it can be done. Akshay, is it clear now, like what position minus one refers to? Exactly, yes, that's previous candle. So similarly, zero will be the current candle, latest ongoing candle, of which close is not fixed yet. So, Mr. Sripathi, we don't have any provision to find previous day's 30-minute range, but current day's 30-minute range you can definitely find out. We have a keyword called ORB for that, which is open range breakout keyword. So I'll just show it to you here. In ORB, you can select again the instrument name, open, high, low, close, which value you want to select of that particular time period. So let's say first 30 minutes will be 9:15 to 9:45. And if I select here, or let's say NFO, Nifty. So if somebody asks like how to select Nifty future, so this is how you have to select Nifty future, NFO, Nifty 50 in current month. So this keyword will return high value of stock between 9:15 to 9:45. Similarly, you can create a keyword to select low value of this time period. And you can use it in condition. If LTP is above this value or below low value, then you can put a trade. So for first 30 minutes of today, you can do it. But for previous day, there is no provision to do it. But in some way, you can handle it. We have a keyword called highest high value or lowest low value of previous X number of candles. So you can use this also for your condition. Also, I'll share a link. So from here you can see how to use keywords, description about each keyword. Yeah, of course, Banu, we have a lot of videos and blogs on our website page. So you can definitely go through them and see how you can build conditions, how you can build strategies from scratch, how can you use all the setting feature that are there. Vedant, you can write to support@thetradetron.tech if you have any doubt. Let's say if you are creating a strategy and you are confused with if you have written correct condition or no, you can just take a screenshot of the conditions and share it on support@thetron.tech. And we will reply you on that if any changes are needed or how you can define that particular condition. And still, if you're not able to do it, then you can just write to support@thetron.tech. We also provide quant services where we will create your strategy for you. It will be charged on hourly basis. So we'll give you a quote how much time and amount will be required to create your strategy. Ankur, on the link of keyword that I have given, it has list of all the indicators. We'll also keep on adding more and update you. Of course, Mr. Mangesh, you can write to support@thetron.tech or you can. You can just fill your strategy details here on this link, and we'll get back to you with the time required for your strategy to be created and efforts on that. Yeah, so everything is parameter based. So once you have your strategy created in your account, you can change the parameters. Let's say if this strategy has Bollinger Band of 22.5 as the parameters. You can definitely anytime change the parameters in your strategy. You don't have to contact support every time once your strategy is completed. Because then the strategy will lie in your own account and you can change it anytime. Sure, Amit. Definitely, please put an email on support. We'll check. T strategy. And it will be great if you can share the screenshot of the conditions that you have written. It will give us a fair idea if you have made any mistakes in that. Maybe that could be a reason why it is not taking the feed. Yes, Mr. Mangesh, Zerodha charges 2,000 rupees a month for their API. So yeah, that will be applicable. TSL is in absolute, it's an absolute profit number. So yeah. So let's say if you have bought a stock worth rupees 1 lakh in the at 100 rupees, you have bought 1,000 shares at 100 rupees, and now it is at 110. So 10,000 is your profit. So TSL values should be relative to 10,000, like that. Mr. Mangesh, we have to check. I think Upstox, I have heard, I'm not sure that Upstox API are, they're not giving away new APIs for their users. So you have to check with Upstox. If you can create an API in Upstox, then we can definitely integrate your account with the Triton account with Upstox for trading. Yes, Akshay, I'll show you how you can do the back test of your strategy once created. So I will not make any changes here. So go to my strategies. In my strategies, you will see the strategy that you have created here. You can do a back test on this. You can decide whether you want to trade on open or close of candle. So in this particular case, we will be trading on open of the candle because I'm checking condition on previous candle. My candle frequency will be 10 minutes. Currently, we have data from Jan 2020. So from here, you can select like for how many days you want to run the back test and just click on back test. Go to back test page. So this strategy will start backtesting now, and once the backtest is completed, you will get a detailed report of it on your email. Okay, guys, thank you for joining. If you have any other questions, you can definitely write to us at support@tradetron.tech. Or you can contact Dinesh.